afternoon. Can you guys hear me? Ooh, that's a little loud. Okay. Okay. Before we get started, I want to say a quick word about my topic today. You'll see in the program that I'll be talking about mercy. However, as often happens through the writing and reflection process, where we want to take things can organically evolve into something else. So that being said, instead of mercy, I think the word humility is more fitting for my message today. So with that, let's get into it. First off, I want to thank you all for having me here today. It is so good to be back at my home on the hilltop. I'm honored to have been asked. I can't be sure, but I think the people in the alumni office asked me because I never stopped talking, especially about this school, so they knew I would have no problem filling 10 minutes. I mean, I really love this place. Birmingham Southern is my heart and my home. Actually, when I think about how much I love BSC, I want to go back and tell my high school teachers about it. Let me tell you why. I remember when I announced my decision to go to Birmingham Southern that one of my favorite high school teachers said to me, "Well, okay, Lindsay, I mean, from where I've heard about where it's located, I'd hesitate to send my own daughter there, or if I did, I would get her a bulletproof car first." What do you say to that? 17-year-old me laughed awkwardly, deflected the comment, thinking it would be the last I would hear about it. But it wasn't. When I arrived on campus in the fall, I noticed this phrase I kept hearing from people in my freshman class. "Don't turn right off campus. Don't turn right." I heard it over and over, some serious, some joking, but I couldn't escape it. Don't turn right. It's dangerous. You don't want to go there. The more I heard it from my classmates, the more I believed it. Now let's fast forward a little bit into my freshman year to E-term, to January. For E-term, I had enrolled in a class with Dr. Tatter called Service Learning in West End and Woodlawn. I'd heard from others that January was a time for fun and relaxation, so I was surprised when our class met in the fall to discuss our schedule, and Dr. Tatter informed us that we'd be working 10, sometimes 12 hours per day during the week, and sleeping at churches and community centers in the neighborhoods on the weekends. It was not going to be easy. And guys, it wasn't. During January, our small group of students dedicated huge amounts of time to all sorts of tasks. We worked at Urban Ministry, painting, cleaning, working in the kitchen and community garden. We did manual labor in the homes of individuals in the area. We delivered groceries. I could go on. We worked every day, and we worked hard. During this time, we also learned about the history of the communities we were working in, about Birmingham's stained past of white flight, and the persistent systemic racism and discrimination that has molded the communities around us. We engaged in lots of reading, writing, individual reflection, and group reflection. We also held many dialogues with community leaders in West End and Woodlawn, lawyers, nurses, teachers, librarians, gardeners, pastors, organizers, and advocates. And as we met all of these community members, I've got to be honest, I felt almost a little disappointed. Now, that's probably not what you thought I was going to say, is it? Let me explain. Here I was, this young, naive teenager who had prided herself on spending her high school years working in Mobile neighborhoods plagued by generational poverty so that she could help. My purpose was to help others. I remember my interview for Birmingham Southern. I had so proudly talked about my goals of becoming a pediatric cardiologist and working for Doctors Without Borders in developing nations. And while I had meant every word of it, I also remember looking around at everyone at the table and thinking to myself, "Man, I am really nailing this. I must be a great person." I thought this class would feel the same, because this community outside our gates had been painted to me by the news and by peers as poor, broken, dangerous, other. And so I thought that I would feel like I was helping, really nailing this. Because these people living here must not be able to help themselves, and I was lucky enough that I could. But that's not what I got. I didn't get the nice little ego stroke I'd been unconsciously hoping for. I had thought turning right meant that I'd be saving someone. And maybe this is where the mercy part comes in. But in thinking in this way, I was unconsciously assigning a lens of pity to how I perceived our neighbors. But then, here I had found myself in a vibrant community full of people who were all working hard and striving for the best and supporting each other and helping themselves. They didn't need my help. Nobody needed my anything. And that was a hard thing to realize. In turning right, I was met by challenges of my own inexperience, privilege, and prejudice. I began the long, constant process of dismantling my well-meaning and so very earnest but misguided perception of myself as a white savior. As you all know, Birmingham Southern is a very special place. Everyone knows everyone here, and we're made up of different people who support each other and lift up one another. We're a family. One semester into my freshman year, I'd started to see these things and had grown to cherish my BSC family. And during my first Jan term, as we interacted with our neighbors in West End, I had the privilege to get to know another family. I remember one morning we went out to deliver groceries to people in West End who couldn't leave their apartments for one reason or another. We loaded onto a bus at Urban Ministry, where we were greeted warmly by a woman who was going to drive us for the day. Her name was Ernestine, but everyone called her Mama Ernestine. Anyone who had the honor of knowing Mama Ernestine before she passed knows that there is no name that could be more fitting. She used to drive kids to school and take people to job interviews or to vote. She would take care of children who needed a home as if they were her own. To know Mama Ernestine was to feel loved, to feel supported, to feel capable. She truly was a mama to every person she met. Watching how Mama E cared for her community in West End gave me a small, small glimpse into the closeness of their family. And I realized that the way Mama E loved on her neighbors in West End was how so many people on campus were choosing to love on me and students now on you every day. Our professors, the admissions counselors, President Flaherty Goldsmith, religious life leaders, Miss Queenie, campus police, the Krulak Institute, the friends from your dorm hall, I could go on forever. In that month, and through college, as I continued to get to know our neighbors, I realized that though every community does have its differences, our communities were more similar than I would have thought freshman year. Over the years, I saw that the world outside our campus gates was not so different, so other, than the world inside them. Now, I don't want to paint a picture of this experience that's all hugs and kumbaya, and 10 minutes feels wildly inadequate to express and convey all the complexities of everything that I want to say. That month was hard. I cried. I got angry. I felt joy alongside deep, deep sadness. I'd begun to discover that the world wasn't the way I'd seen it before. It wasn't a place full of people who were different from me and who needed saving. One of my favorite quotes is by Lilla Watson, an Aboriginal elder and activist from Australia. You may have heard it before. "If you have come here to help me, you are wasting your time. But if you have come because your liberation is bound up with mine, then let us work together." BSC held my hand during my first steps into understanding what she meant, and I'm still striving to understand each day. So what is your right off campus? Where are the places? Who are the people you've been taught to avoid? Or who are the people you think need your help? If you don't take your right off campus, wherever or whomever that is for you, then it will never be anything to you besides different, dangerous, and other. Birmingham Southern helped me make the decision to turn right and to continue turning right. And that taught me a great deal about humility. It helped me understand that we cannot and must not work for others. No, we must work by and with others. It is in this way that we move forward ever. Thank you.